Welcome to Late Night Storytime. I'm your host, Ida Reynolds. Tonight we have a very special episode. We have questions from the fans themselves. Tonight we'll be interviewing two characters from Jerry Spinelli's book, Milkweed, and one very special guest. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the man himself, Jerry Spinelli. Good evening, Mr. Spinelli, and welcome to Late Night Storytime.
Please, call me Jerry, and it's been a pleasure so far attending.
Well, Jerry, we have questions from the fans themselves, so shall we begin?
Yes, please.
All right. Question number one comes from BaldDude6S.
Yes!
So, the first question, why did you decide to write this story in the time period you did?
Well, with this being a historical fiction book and all, I really wanted to write a book that showed what it would be like being a Jew during the Holocaust, to create my own characters and their own special personalities.
Good answer. Okay, the next question. Let's see. Why did you decide to call the book Milkweed?
The name came from when Janina realized that Milkweed was her angel, and that letting go of what was and accepting what's going to be. So, really, milkweed is a metaphor for freedom.
Interesting. Okay, and our final question is, what message did you intend to have people take away from this story?
I really wanted people to have a feel for what Jews had to go through during the Holocaust. I wanted people to feel like they could never give up and always have hope.
Great answer. Well, that concludes our time with Jerry Spinelli. Jerry, thank you so much. Next, we'll be back with two more characters from Milkweed. Welcome back. We'll now be interviewing Misha and Janina from Milkweed.
What are you doing? Stop!
Okay, Misha and Janina, would you two like to introduce yourselves?
Yes, I'm Janina, and I'm the main character and the best character.
Actually, I'm the main
okay.
character.
Okay, let's get to the questions. First question is from Misha. Would you rather live a free life in Warsaw alone or a life with the Milgrams in the ghetto?
He would rather live with the Milgrams.
Actually, I think if I was free, I would have to worry less about the jackboots.
Ouch! But on the other hand, with the Milgrams, they keep me company and I feel very close to them.
So, told you so.
Okay, next question goes to Janina. How has living with Misha in the ghetto made life better?
With Misha there, we get free food every night. I have someone to beat in pickup sticks, and there's a lot more competition. Of course, I always win.
I win sometimes too.
Okay, next question goes to Misha. What do you think would have happened if Yuri wasn't there to help you?
I think I would have been caught by the jackboots until then and there. But it would have been sent to the train at the end.
Yeah, likely. Next question goes to Janina. If you hadn't gone on the train, would you have liked to be a part of Misha's happy ending?
Of course. I would have been a big help for Misha while he was struggling over in America. So I could have prevented that.
First of all, we're going to struggle.
Yes, I'd love to get a North woman.
All right, next question is for Janina. All right. Why were you so determined to get on the train?
Maybe if Misha hadn't pestered me so much about staying away from it, maybe I would. But I also wanted to find Top Top. Duh.
That was stupid of you.
Okay. And the final question goes to Misha. What was going through your mind when you saw Yuri working as a flop?
Well, since you were so helpful to me while we were roaming and hiding in Warsaw, I didn't really have any concerns about them.
Okay. Great answer. Well, thank you everyone for watching Late Night Storytime. I'm your host.